Subsequently, a pivotal meeting was held at the site, bringing together the miners, district leaders and Kamuntu himself. The artisanal miners accused Kamuntu Investment Uganda Limited of withholding payments and encroaching upon their rightful deposits nestled within their lands. With a plea for ministry intervention, the miners yearned for a just and equitable resolution to their grievances. These declared their interests to see the ministry help them in finding a solution to the problem.
Work team for 12 years. We could mine, give him material after he bring money. Then after some time, he started just we give him material up to like 40 million, he don't give anything. Then after a period, me myself, I'm demanding him 27 million. If he's here, he can witness. I'm not lying. We were chatting on the WhatsApp. The time I stopped giving him material, I was demanding him 42 million. He gave me 15 million. I said, you honorable, me and you, who should be working on someone's money? Because I'm poorer than you. Then why do you just pay me like that?
On the other side of the dispute, Moses Kamuntu Monjera staunchly dismissed the accusations leveled against his company, vehemently asserting that the miners had no concrete evidence to support their claims. He maintained that he had leased the land in question and made full payments to the rightful landowners. Furthermore, he contended that the association formed by the miners was a reactionary move birthed in response to the ongoing feud.
I own 200 acres of land in the Muko mine. I don't own the license and I've never complained. Have I ever complained? No. But you can exchange. Give me Muko and give Batakai. I don't have any problem. Yes. You give me Muko if it is now mining in people's villages. Also let me go and mine in my village. But now, to mobilize people to come and terrorize here without evidence. The first case we had was I encroached in Dr. Kawateri's land. That one says, he has said I've never encroached in his land.
Responding to the pleas, Minister Nankabirwa extended assurance to the miners of her commitment to end the disagreement.
Mulimu gwange n'abantu bange kubayamba association yeyo efune license etandika okusima. No kuba wabula era neteeka ligamba muteekwa okubanga mu association yammwe.
Addressing the matter of non-payment, Nankabirwa added that she would join hands with the Attorney General's office to find out if the miners were not really paid by the company and task it to pay them.
Ngamba gambye nti ba lawyer bange babiwuliddeko tugenda kutandika okwengejinga ne colleague wafe onarebo Kamuntu tulabe ekinaba kisoboka bobanga okakasiza ddala nga waliwo obukakafu nti sente tebazikuwa obukakafu obwo ne bwogenda mu kkooti bajja bukusaba.
Stefan Kasabia, the Rwanda LC5 chairperson, commended the move by the ministry to intervene in the conflict, saying that it had affected the development of the district.
For you having made time to come and solve these wrangles because they have given us instability in these areas. One of the things which I want to put forward when I see it is that stability is very key to development. Now the moment these people are disagreeing, when they are not working together, certainly we cannot develop in this area.
In June 2023, Kamuntu appeared in Rwanda District with investors under Steam Investments Limited, where they surveyed a 420-acre public land located in Rugarambiro Village, Muko Sub-County, with an interest to establish a multi-billion iron ore plant in the district. Story by Job Namanya for the news.